while the shipyard is a woman.
So, just as Wojtek said previously, I'm just an activist, and yeah, that's it. Well, okay, so this is the... I have much, definitely too long presentation, so I will skip some parts of it, but if you want to ask me about any aspect of Shipyard is a Female project, then just ask me, I will be here around for some time. So, our project was made thanks to mostly EEA grants, and we are not developers in any way. We are not educated as such. However, we do know a lot about Shipyard, and one of the things that we know about the Shipyard is that Shipyard, Gdansk Shipyard, which was the biggest and the most important company, or maybe not company, but public workplace. It was the biggest workplace in this region, and as such, it was also a witness of very many historical events. However, it is maybe some of you have seen it, because some of you went to Shipyard sightseeing with Mr. Maciej Butania, and this is how it started. We started to we became a guide around Shipyard, following the steps of female workers over there, and through interviews which are made with the oral history method, which means that we ask a question and we listen to the story and we listen for hours and hours and hours, not asking any more questions but only listening. We created audio guides and podcasts, and the natural consequence of this audio guide and podcasts was to engage senior citizens, which were our interlocutors, to make them learn also about new technologies. So the part of this big project was also teaching how to use computers and apps, but we also meet with each other during events that were connected somehow with Shipyard's history. And then we listened to more and more stories. Therefore, the most crucial part of our initiative was to show that Shipyard is not only male-centered workplace, which in Polish historical discourse is pretty explicit. It's a man. It is both taught at schools and shown in historical documents that there were only men going on strike in 1980s, men during strikes in 1970s. Women were waiting, women were not participating because they were not workers. And this is the part that it's not true, because since 1950, every department, every workshop had at least one or two female workers, which means there were a lot of them, because Shipyard engaged at least 100,000 people, sometimes 30,000 people at once. So this is a lot. This is a lot of history, and the idea of the app was not only to show somehow how the Shipyard has changed, because you can travel through the Shipyard with point by point with this app, but you can also sit at home and listen and read by yourself in some kind of an interactive album. So we think of a Shipyard as of a city that was inside of a city, and female workers were the citizens of the city. However, that's why this is so important to show how important and crucial was their role and how we did it. The app is divided into three main parts, but there are much more. The main part is a map, which is an interactive map connected to Google Maps. which is also showing the parts of the shipyard that is now forbidden to go inside, and which is very frustrating because this is both very important heritage buildings over there, and they are interconnected with the history of shipyard. So, not to destroy the narrative, we also included those points into the shipyard map. However, it's very difficult to get there. Some of the photos that are made in our app were made by sneaking in and running away from the security guards. So we have also an archived photographs of those places, so we can see how it changed, and we can also see where and how people work. And every part of this map is connected with two things, with a place and with a voice. So every description of a place is not only technical description, like 19th century building of some architect in historical importance, it's also the very specific story connected to it, with the history, for instance, when some female workers told us stories about people that were stealing from the magazines during the during some kind of historical period. So, in general, there are lots of stories, and they are available also to understand in English because we have transcript and translation underneath. So if you want to hear the voice, you can hear the voice in Polish, but you can also read the translation down down the part of the section. So we tried to make this app also available for the people that are with some partial disabilities, such as sight problems or hearing problems. So everything is transcribed, and everything can be also read by Google Talkbox or the other thing that is on iOS, but I don't remember how it's called. So what we wanted to do was to create some kind of connection between innovation. Shipyard was innovative, so it was an obvious choice, and tradition, which is also the fact that shipyard is a part of Gdańsk heritage. And to do so, we also engaged senior citizens to test the app. And to be honest, the most important people that received or tested the app or used it for sightseeing, those were the shipyard workers that gave their voice to the app. So for us, they are the most important ones because this is their history, that their her story actually. So this part was the most important for us to achieve, and this was actually the goal. So the very important part is that history of shipyard is disappearing, and usually the history of female participants of any kind of history is disappearing even quicker. That's why we wanted to use the newest, the most available ways to tell the story. And for maybe Polish, mostly Polish audience, in the middle of this photograph is a very important person for Polish history, is Anna Walentynowicz. She was also a shipyard worker, and she was a welder. So, not very female thing to do. However, she was the best in it. So, I think that's all. If you want to contact us, we are available for many projects, mostly from female perspective, but not only. So, just contact us, and thank you so much.